Alright guys, of course, we have one of the most intriguing positions in the draft to go through today. That, of course, is the 2024 NFL cornerback draft class. Of course, we have a lot of guys to go through. Should be a fun video to do. We got some high-quality prospects, middle first round type of guys. Very interesting, what is called position group. Let's get right into it. What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Fun NFL. Of course, please like and subscribe. Hope you guys enjoy the 2024 NFL Draft cornerback prospect rankings. We have eight guys to go through. I'm going to be honest. These eight guys, they're the best cornerbacks in this draft class. This is honestly my favorite part of the year when it comes to these positions. This is my favorite, of course, position to also go through, at least this year's draft. And I like all these guys. I really love their games. There's a couple guys in particular I really, really like, but obviously this is a cornerback class that there's really no like weakness in. They have like eight good solid corners that I could really see being actually starters in the league at this point. Yeah, maybe a dropout after that, but there are eight guys I think that are like consensus very, very good players. And I think, again, all these guys, it's like splitting hairs with some of them. So, yeah, some guys are going to be a little lower. Some are going to be a little higher. But it's a very even group. And, again, have their weaknesses, have their strengths. This is, again, this is my favorite position in this 2024 NFL draft. Should be really fun to go through these prospects. Let's start out with our first guy, which is the mystery. Oh, yeah, it's Khalil McKinstry, who, of course, was the number one, what is called, DB prospect going into the year. Where is he now? Well, let's get right into him and see how he did in 2023.
For the Razorbacks. That might be a lateral, and there's a flag down, and so is Hazelwood.
Yeah, it looked to me like an easy.
All right, the first prospect we'll be going through today, of course, is the Alabama man, the three-year starter, of course, a freshman as well. That would be Khalil McKinstry, of course. He did opt out of his senior season to enter the 2024 NFL Draft, and here he is, again, with all these other dudes trying to get picked in the first round. But again, you look at him, he's a little undersized, 1-99, would definitely be a little generous for him. 5'11", you could argue is too. Again, looking at how he did project going into last year, again, the 2023 college football season, he was the number one corner. He didn't play up to that standard for sure, but again, overall did what he usually saw. Some of the other guys did have better and more impressive seasons. Not as much on film, but obviously overall. Had 27 solo tackles. That's not total tackles. And 7 passes defended again. He did have some issues against Xavier Worthy, again, just with speed and stuff like that, and not being able to line up and press as much with, again, the run game that Texas had at the beginning of last year. Again, looking at it more, again, he does not have too much versatility either. We'll talk about that as well, but that's basically the overview for him. Again, looking at, he did have an 88.8 PFF grade, though, which ranked 12th in the country, so it wasn't like he had a bad year by any means. Again, this is the baseline. 32 total tackles, though, again, this is just not right. This is just messed up. But he also, of course, did have 7 pass defended, as I already mentioned. But getting into it, again, Marshawn Lattimore is his comparison. I think this is a more potential thing than anything else. Again, we'll get more on that again when we get to this, but yeah, that's his comparison. Either way, though, in man coverage, I gotta give him an 86. I think he's a very good man corner, again, going into the league, and just the way he's able to stick on receivers and not give up too much separation, and he never really gets off him either, just that focus, and that he never really has a lapse, which I think is very big for a corner like him. But that's only in man, because in zone, he has a lot of lapses, and again, right now, it's below average. It is an issue. Again, he's not doesn't have that natural instinct or feel, and really, in most zone coverages, really likes to stay, what is called, behind receivers, which, again, is obviously a good thing, but at the same point, he does get beat underneath a good amount, and of course, with his tackling not being up to par sometimes, again, being a little bit too aggressive, that does hurt him. Press coverage, obviously, it's going to be elite. I mean, you watch him on film, it's really cool to see. Obviously, he does have some issues here and there with, what is it called? Using his hands a little bit too much, but that's not as big as an issue I think people do, what it's called, inflate it to be. But then again, on film, this is what really sticks out with him. Standard coverage, I'm just talking, again, alignment normally. Again, usually, he's going to be limited because most guys are going to know, receivers are going to know he is and going to be playing man coverage, which, again, just kind of take away his ability to, again, manipulate their route. But overall, I do think, again, in standard, again, just he's a little limited, but overall, I don't think he's a bad standard set corner. Physicality, yeah, this is something that, again, he gets a little high and low on, but I'll give it an 84. Against the run, definitely needs to improve there, but again, in coverage, he's going to knock guys around. Maybe more in the air, if he can knock guys off the ball, that would be even better. Off-snap explosiveness, I'll give this a 75. He's not the most explosive corner by any means. It's good, but I don't even know if it's good. It's around average. You could argue it's above average, but again, on film, it didn't really pop off the screen, so that's why I'll give it average. And now he gets completely toasted, though. Ball skills, again, something he's really got to work on. He's got brick hands right now. That's just the simple truth about it. But again, he does have some decent coordination overall, again, with some of the plays you see from him. But I don't think he has it right now. Playmaking ability, again, they're not going to make many big plays. I don't think it's bad as ball skills. Again, this is more with contested catches than he's got to work on it there. But again, playmaking ability, I do think, again, he is able to force fumbles at a pretty decent clip going into the league. Does project well there. But again, it just doesn't have the production. So that's why I give him a 63. Speed, 82. I think he has decent speed. Again, it's better than decent, to be honest. It's probably really good. But the reason it's not, again, anything higher is that because we don't really have to see the potential there. Again, he does really get beat deep, which is good favor, again, with the press coverage there. Very rare ability there. But at the same point, I'm not going to say he's going to be some, like, great boundary corner when it comes to zone, because the best zone corners are the fastest corners in the league, and he's just not that. Hip fluidity, he does have stiff hips, but I don't think it's the end-all, be-all for him, considering, again, what he can do otherwise. And also, his hips aren't, like, complete, like, locked, like another guy will get to actually next. So that's what I got there. Agility-wise, it's a little better. I'll give it a 77, actually. He does take on blocks well with it, as well as the fact that, again, it's really hard for a runner to, again, escape his grasp when he's able to, again, get in a good position there. Play recognition, I'll give this a 72. Doesn't diagnose the run very well at all, but, again, in coverage, he does know usually what a receiver is going to try to attack on him as the play develops, which, again, is really good. Reading the quarterback, again, he isn't going to be some, again, crazy zone type of guy, but when, again, he does have the opportunity going up against a receiver who is not straight up, just never going to beat him, he does make some really nice plays and can completely blow plays up just off what the quarterback's going to do with his feet. I really like what I see there. He does punish him. I'll give it an 83. It can be really good. He has a ton of potential there as well. Concentration, very concentrated corner. Again, he does have those lapses in zone coverage, so it's probably going to come around to a 73. It's average overall, just very good man concentration in zone, though. He has a lot of work to do there. Quickness, he's pretty quick, but it's not like fluid, so that's why I gotta give him a 76. Length, again, he can't get down and make the ball, a lot of plays on the ball. Also, the fact that, again, receivers do have a hard time, again, getting out of his wing, what is called wingspin, which, again, I think is a big part of his game. So I'll give that an 81. It is really good, but again, it's just right on that border there. Tackling, not consistent, but I do think he could be a pretty talented tackler. At least right now, it's got to be a 73 because he does miss some tackles, and I think that could be an issue. Discipline, again, despite him being a pretty physical player, again, being impressed, and again, a lot of these guys commonly do have issues with that, he does not, which I think is a very big factor. I think he does have special discipline and coverage. He rarely gets flagged for a penalty, and when he does, he's going to get a couple just naturally for the way he plays, but even then, that could be called a stretch. Athleticism, not the most athletic corner. That will, I think, hurt him at times in the league, but again, outside of that, he is a pretty athletic dude. Nothing crazy, though, which again, could arguably hurt him. Potential, I think he could be a Pro Bowl corner. That's why I got to give him an 85. Again, developing into Marshon Lattimore is a realistic possibility for him. The issues, again, I think that they both had, or what Marshon Lattimore had coming out, was the fact that, again, he really wasn't much of a playmaker, which, again, he did turn out to be. Cooley McKinstry, if he does develop his zone, what is called zone game a little more, and is able to, again, not just focus on, what is it called, staying, like, literally sticking to a receiver, he could have a lot of success with this type of plays, as well as being proactive, what is it called, when it comes to those jump balls. But if he gets better there, again, this guy could be a really good corner. I'm not going to say he's going to be an elite one at any point, but again, I think he could be a really good one. So, 77.9 overall grade for him. I think that's pretty fair for who's one of the best corners in this draft class.
Hit as he throws. Intercepted. There he is, Cooper DeJean. And he's got some space in front. DeJean still on his feet across the 25. DeJean.
Mitchell. Next guy is a do-it-all safety cornerback, whatever you want to call him, Cooper DeJean. Again, he is polarizing because of that, but he is 6'1", 210. He's a thick 210, too. He's a dense boy. But yeah, I don't think you're in a 4-4. Did he even run the 40? Whatever, though. This dude's just super freaking versatile. It's kind of crazy. Big playmaker. Makes a lot of different plays. Again, he's just a complete player. There's no way around it. But stick him anywhere in the secondary, and he will thrive. Again, had 41 tackles, 2 picks, 5 pass defense, and 23. But again, he did have a lower leg injury, which, again, I think could be critical. Again, at safety and slot corner, although they feel he could be an outside corner, which, again, that actually is true. He does have the physicality for sure. But, again, he does lack the juice that could make him better. He did not work out the combine, blah, blah, blah. He's aiming before the 2021 draft. Whatever. You get the point there. He did have a 77.4 PFF grade for a cornerback, which, again, isn't great. But, again, watching his upside, it's immense. Again, his numbers last year, again, 2 picks. He didn't have a pick 6. He had 3 pick 6s in 2022. And I think, yeah, 2022, he was set up for a little bit more success without, again, a true number. They had one true, outside corner, of course. I don't think he got drafted in the league. What was his name? Whatever, though. Oh, or, yeah. But yeah, looking at last year, and he did have a couple of, did have some games where he did struggle, but again, 2022 was his best year in college. Wasn't nearly as good last year on film or overall, but again, still had a pretty solid year for, again, what you'd expect from him. So, I'm not too mad about it. Again, just a little disappointing for, again, what you really want to see from him, but again, still a very, very good prospect, obviously. Again, in his man coverage, it's kind of hard to project because of the fact that, again, he didn't really have to face that many elite receivers the whole year. But again, against a guy like Roman Wilson, he doesn't even play Roman Wilson. Did they play? Oh, I'm just thinking of, like, receivers he played against. Oh, what was his name? Oh, there was a guy in Minnesota. He was actually pretty good. But, man coverage, against fast receivers, he did struggle a little bit more. But I'll give him a, 72. On film, again, it wasn't anything impressive or overly impressive, to be exact. Again, he did have some pretty good versatility, and he did stick on some of those bigger receivers that weren't as agile. Zone coverage, it's a lot better. I'll give it an 86, actually. Again, I think his zone coverage is very underrated. Especially in those flat routes, very good discipline, really good at feeling those out. Again, he doesn't give up anything underneath, which, again, is really rare for most corners. Press coverage, doesn't have the quickest hands, but, again, his physicality and his ability to get up the line quick is really good. So I'll give it a 78. Standard coverage, this is where he thrives a lot, not off as much as you think it would, but overall in standard I'll probably give him an 89. Again, yeah, he's really good here. Again, standard coverage is obviously, like, again, just lining up normally, but again, he's just really good in this second game, get in the groove. Yeah, off coverage isn't as great. Again, if you don't know why I don't have off coverage here, again, if you're a corner and you can't play off, I mean, like, come on, bro. But yeah, 89 there. Physicality, I'm not gonna give this a 90. I'll give this probably an 86. But yeah, it's whatever, I guess. But again, watching him play, again, it's pretty good. But again, you kind of expect that from, again, watching him play. Like, it's just there. It's not, like, popping up the screen, per se. But it is decent. Off-snap explosiveness, again, we're talking about, like, again, originally given 86 because he does, like, every play. Like, you're expecting it from him. Off-snap explosiveness, though, yeah, this is something where he does struggle a little bit, 64. Again, with the press, again, he does get up the line well and is able to get on guys. But same point, again, if you blow up, beat him off the line, you're gone. Ball skills, it's pretty good, but again, it's more the fact that he's opportunistic than actually making big plays on jump balls, but he's still pretty good. Playmaking ability, again, does force a lot of turnovers. I'd say he's one of the better players in this entire draft, what it's called, at making plays, again, just being able to force turnovers. So for that reason, I'll give him an 84. Nothing, again, out of the ordinary, but again, he does at times make those plays that a lot of other guys wouldn't try to make. Speed, again, not the fastest guy in the world, but he does have good enough speed to the point where, again, he can stick on a lot of different receivers. I'll give him an 80. I think it is above average. Hip fluidity, yeah. He's got, like, really stiff hips. It's, like, a concern. It's bad. At least right now. But I think he could work with it in the league, but, again, as a slot, he's got a really, again, if he doesn't get better there, some guys are going to cook him. So, again, his hips, they got a lot of work to do. Agility, it's better. It's still not great. Give it a 56. Again, against the run, if he can play better there, I think, again, he would have better agility overall. Anticipation of this player recognition, very good. I'll give this an 84. Reading the quarterback, again, it really depends on, again, what he's asked to do on every given play. As a free safety, he's elite. What it's called, when he can read the quarterback, but again, in playing man on the boundary, is very limited with that. So, overall, I'll probably have to give him around a 72. So, around average. Concentration is a little bit all over the place at times, especially, again, when he does get beat. When he does get beat, especially, again, when it comes to tackling, too. 73. Again, doesn't get beat underneath, but when it comes to those intermediate plays, you can just see, again, when he does flip his hips, again, because the receiver does beat, show one way, he does get out of his, what it's called, leverage, which, again, is an issue. Length on, quickness, I mean, it's obvious. It's an 83. It's really good. It's not elite, but, again, especially against the one he just run, he just gets upfield and is able to make tackles, which, again, I think is really big there. Length, it's an issue, but it's not like it's almost bad, but it's not like every single player, like, Jesus, bro, if he was just a little longer, or I don't even put it like that, if he was just able to stretch a little more to get to that ball, he would have made a huge play. But yeah, again, especially on those intermediate passes, again, on those, like, again, you don't even have to put it on the receiver exactly. Cooper DeGene won't just want to be able to get there. Tackling, probably a 94. I think he's a really good tackler for a corner, like, very consistent. Yeah, maybe that doesn't bring the physicality all the time, again, because you just watch him, again, it's just every play, but, yeah, 94, he's a very good tackler. Discipline, again, not always the most disciplined. You can, again, beat him in a man of decent bit, again, especially if you're a receiver, but, again, it's hard to beat him on double moves, again. I think it is a pretty weird when you watch him play, but it's kind of how it is. Athleticism, 86, again, for a guy his, stature, he shouldn't be able to do what he does. potential. I really do think he could be one of the better what is called DBs in the league. I'm not even kidding. Like, I think he has elite potential. That's why Javon Holland's his comparison, which I actually do like a lot too. Javon Holland obviously isn't a corner like he is, but again, I really do like that consistency there. His zip fluidity, I don't think we'll stick him as a boundary corner consistently in the league. But again, a guy like Josh Metellus, who again played like 8 positions last year, again, I think that's really good comparison for them in that sense, again, for the versatility. Yeah, he's not this level. He's much better than a C-minus level prospect, guys. Let me just be honest there. Again, his hip fluidity is a big issue right now. Again, that's kind of the 46, but if I took that out of the equation, it would be around this, which, again, I think is a lot more fair for him. So, again, the hip fluidity is an issue, but I think that does hold him back from, you know, honestly, an elite level prospect. If he had better hips and he was able to move them a lot better, he'd be an elite prospect. But, again, he just doesn't have that, so he's not an elite prospect, and that's why Javon Holland is his comparison. That is all I got for you guys on Cooper DeJean.
To the code, all these holes for the street. I put it in her nose, it's gonna make up.
Now, on our third guy, that would be TJ Tampa, the Iowa State. What is it called? Upper Statesman, of course. He was a senior last year and had his best year at Iowa State, which notched him into this video, obviously. Well, also, again, combine wasn't as great as I think it could have been. Was pretty disappointing overall, in my opinion. But again, 6'1", he is 190, which, again, is a little skinny for, again, that height of his. He's a big corner, like, he can really move well, again. With that, again, laterally for sure, but again, you watch him, there are issues, obviously, but again, he did have a very good season for, again, a senior. Really, again, got him here, because again, he obviously wasn't, again, really proven to be, again, a high pick, but hey, he could be, honestly, I think, again, he could be a second-round pick, again, just considering how he, had a senior season. Again, on film, he's great, too. But again, he did have 44 tackles, 3 tackles for loss, 2 interceptions, only for 1 yard, yes, but he also had 7 passes defended, and showed very good length for Cyclones. Again, looking at his number, 75.8 PFF grade, again, baseline around 200, but again, I just don't think it's fair. Yes, he did get burned a couple times this year, that's just the simple truth about it, but TJ Tampa I like a lot, because again, just on film, plays very well. Efedim Alfonwu is his comparison, and Efedim Alfonwu had like 4 picks in like the last like 5 games this season. He just ended 2023 with his best season of his career. Again, really just starting to develop into that really good player for the Lions, which of course they did draft him to be. Either way, TJ Tampa, and man, he's not super consistent, but I can see the potential. Right now, though, it's around a 75. It's around average. Simple truth about it. He gets beat. Again, gives up a lot of separation, especially on those deeper routes. When again he does get aggressive, but then on the flip side, when he's conservative, it's really hard to get him. Turning his hips there. Zone coverage. It's better, but it's not much. Good around 77. And he's just kind of an average cover type of guy overall. Again, from like the consistency we've seen. Press coverage, he's a little better in, but it's nothing crazy. I'll give it like a 78. Again, I'll probably say it's above average, just by the littlest better. Standard coverage, again, most guys are decent here, but again, with him, I think he could definitely get a little bit better, 66. Physicality, very physical corner, again, in a lot of different ways. Maybe he doesn't have the same punch that Khalil McKinstry has, or the same, just again, every single down and down, with how he plays in Cooper DeJean. But again, you need that from TJ Tampa, though, with a lot of the other stuff he offers. Off-snap explosiveness, again, this is probably his biggest weakness, at least right now, 52. He got the times he did get burned, it was because he wasn't ready off the snap. Ball skills, they're very good. I'll give this an 87. It's hard to beat him on jump balls. Simple truth about it there. There are guys who I think are better, but he's still very good. Playmaking ability, I will give this an 84. I think, again, he could be a guy who could be essential to what is called forcing fumbles. Again, maybe forces 2 or 3 a season at best, in my opinion. Speed, he's slow. I'm sorry, that's just simple truth about it. Not the fastest dude. You can burn him over the top again if he's not ready. Hip fluidity, actually really good for, again, a guy who's 6'1". Again, when you look at him, it's hard to beat him there at 84. I actually really like it. Agility, also very good. I'll give this an 87. Bigger blocker's going to have a really hard time to actually get into his path, considering the fact that he can't just get around him very easily. Very slippery corner there. Play recognition, again, it depends on if he's going against a better route runner. This is something he definitely needs to work on, because again, he's just assuming stuff that just won't happen. Simple as that. Again, running backs as well in the open field, he's got to be a little bit more aware of stuff like this. I'll give it 74 though. And he does read the quarterback very well. Again, underneath, he does give him those plays a lot, but when it comes to those, again, the flat routes over the top, he just feasts on those again like it's lunch. 82. Concentration, pretty good. I really see him again get beat there. Again, a lot of splash plays, yes. But again, overall, those splash plays that he does give up does compensate for the fact that, again, in man, he's usually at least not getting completely blown over. Quickness, again, in the small area, especially again underneath, he does wrap up pretty well. Not great, though. Length, yeah, that's probably going to go as a 92. This is the best thing about him. He does have elite length, in my opinion. Tackling-wise, not super consistent. I think it is below average, at least at this point. I'll give it a 64. Discipline, again, he can't get beat on those double moves here and there. But overall, again, on film, I didn't really see too many plays where I'm like, yeah, he just completely, sold on that. Athleticism, though, I don't know. It's like, he is athletic, but it's not, like, overwhelming. So I'll give it a 78. Potential, 82. I think he'd be a solid starter, but I don't know. I don't think he'd be really good. I'll give him, like, a 77. Because I think he'd be a solid starter, but I never see this guy actually, like, becoming a Pro Bowler or anything, like, crazily, to be completely honest with you guys. I think he could be very a solid player, obviously. Again, reliable corner for, like, 5 or 6 years. I do think he has that longevity, but I do think it'll take him a year or two to really get to that. I don't know about the risk-reward with this guy, but TJ Tampa, again, does have a lot of good tools that I think could help him become a starting caliber corner, but overall, not the most impressive prospect.
Terry and Arnold from the goal line. Gets to the 20.
Ain't gonna wake up at they sleep. You can't hear that switch, but you can't hear them niggas scream.
All right, okay, from Cooley McKinstry first to Taron Arnold at fourth, that would be, again, his what it's called, partner in crime, who, of course, didn't start his freshman season, but obviously with a lot of upside, had an immense, well, guess kind of junior season, redshirt, what it's called, sophomore season, to, of course, get into this spot, again, I guess redshirt, redshirt sophomore, I guess, season, of course, in which did really escalate up this board. Also, the fact that, again, he just has a lot of intangibles that I think will be essential to him being a very good corner in the NFL. But, again, he did total 61 tackles, 5 picks, 11 pass defended. A lack of speed is really his only real flaw, I guess. But that might be a stretch, dude. This guy's really good, guys. There's no way around it. Like, a natural athlete, ton of potential. Yeah, I do think there are underlying things in the film that do sometimes pop up. It doesn't always wow you when I think he could. But overall, again, just a really good player. Again, 85.4 PFF grade, 13th. Him and Cooley McKinstry, again, lock on. Both those guys are elite. I think they both dead off each other very, very well. And it's really hard to throw the ball, again, deep or really get the ball downfield against that Alabama secondary last year. Again, looking at it overall, 63 total tackles from, again, 6.5 for loss. 1 sack, which, again, actually was a very nice play. I think that could be very useful for him in the league. 12 passes defended, more like, I think, 10, not 11 either. He got a couple of those, but either way, forced fumble, and also, again, 5 picks for 69 yards. Nice. Again, show that playmaking ability as well, which, again, is essential to being a higher picked cornerback. Either way, though, again, Trayvon Diggs, that doesn't get cooked. Again, that is, again, when I get to his potential, I will tell you why that is. Man coverage, he sticks on guys. Again, the reason it's not, like, special or elite, in my opinion, it's really good, is because he does tend to give up separation underneath, and with the fact that he, again, doesn't have the, like, again, burst that I think some of these other, slot or under, yak receivers do have, I think that could be something where he does give up a big play here and there. Again, that's really the only way you give up a big play, though. Zone coverage, he is an elite zone corner, in my opinion. I really think this is something that, again, needs to be stressed about people. In off coverage, he is so hard for a receiver to get open against. Again, when if you go underneath, he'll smash you in the face. You try to go over the top one, you won't, because if you try to go inside, the safety will be there. Very good in zone. Like, again, especially with leverage, he just doesn't give anything up. It's very cool to watch. Press coverage, again, you don't see this as much with him. Again, he's more that off type of corner, but in the few instances I did see him there, I'll give him a 73. I think he did a decent job. Nothing special, though, and again, I don't think you'd want to put him there too much in the NFL in this spot. Standard coverage, again, he played a lot of this in man. Again, the zone, you just don't want to tell that both off, again, a lot, with, of course, Alabama's DC. And standard, though, he does do a decent job. Again, I overall think, again, he could definitely develop into a more of an, what is called, an attack, a tactive instinct in standard, what is called, standard sets, but overall, does do a decent job there. Physicality, does climb up pretty well, again, to stop the run, but again, when it comes into actual coverage, is a little bit conservative with that, and again, doesn't always try to, again, make the play that is necessary to force that incompletion. I'll give him an 80, though, because, again, he does get, what is called, he is pretty physical against the run. Off the ball explosiveness, not that great, to be honest. I'll probably give this around a, probably below average, 68. Again, you rarely see him again impressed because of that. He just doesn't have the, what it's called, the juice off the line to really, keep up with guys and make sure, again, they don't make a play. Ball skills, they're very good. I'll probably give this a 92, a 90, it's borderline special. To be honest, he's got hops, so that really helps too. But, yeah, you're not going to complete a jump auto. Again, maybe A.J. Brown, someone like that, or DeAndre Hopkins. Again, if he does get a good shot there, maybe makes a play on him. That's, like, once in a while, though, because it's really hard to get up there with him and also, again, be have the physicality to, again, take the ball away from him because he's really good up there. Playmaking ability, I don't know how to put this. He is very good again. The fact that he isn't always going to try to make the play, I think, does hinder him a little bit. So I'll give it a 76, though. Speed, not the fastest guy, but I think it is doable. I'll give it a 78. Again, not great over the middle intermediate. Again, his fluidity, I think, is very good. But again, the speed overall isn't great. Again, more of a fluid player for sure. I'll give this an 86. Very good fluidity. Agility, not as great, but I'll give it a 77, considering the fact that, again, I really don't see any plays where that's a big problem. Play recognition could use a little bit of work, but I'll give it a 73 because, again, it's not, again, too big of an issue. Reading the quarterback does a good job with this, again, especially in zone, obviously. 83. It's more the receiver he's worried about, though, which, again, I think could develop a little bit more, again, as he gets, what it's called, more developed. Concentration. Pretty good in concentration, but sometimes he does just kind of, like, wander off, especially in zone. It's kind of funny. But, yeah, again, that's more just, again, he does get a little bored. But, yeah, 75. Quickness, very quick player. He's got special quickness, guys. Again, he just move. Again, when it comes in over the middle, a guy can get. He doesn't always accelerate to the ball very well, but again, he is a quick corner. It's just like, again, he snaps really well. Length, I'll give it a 77. Again, he's a little conservative, but I think, again, he just doesn't have the confidence yet. I think he does have naturally, though. Tackling, not great, probably. I don't know, he's kind of a crappy tackler. I'll give it a 61. Discipline, pretty disciplined. Again, you can get him on a double moving man once in a while. That's like once in a great while. Athleticism, I'm being completely honest, guys, I don't know how that got there. But what the heck, bro? No, that's just not right. There we go. All right. Athleticism, he's a really good athlete. I'll give him an 87. I don't think he's an elite athlete, but he's a really good one for sure. Potential, again, Trayvon Diggs, you can argue, is a top 10 corner. Again, he did have that unfortunate injury, but last year when he did play, he was very, very good. He doesn't get burned as much as he used to, which, again, is really how he developed. Again, he did have that, of course, that 11 pick season. But, yeah, Trayvon Diggs overall, again, is more developed into kind of, like, again, a more of a cover guy for sure. But, again, still is a pretty quality guy in terms of, what is it called? Again, being able to make a playmaker, which, again, I think he could become. And I really don't see Trayvon Taron Arnold having a problem with him getting burned. So, again, he will get burned. Everyone does, but not as much, obviously. It's not even close to the extent that Trayvon, I think, would. Again, very similar in their what it's called. Footwork for sure, but overall, I'll probably give him for his potential an 87. I don't think he actually has the highest potential out of all these corners, to be honest, but I think, and from what I saw, I really like that, and again, that's why it comes out to around an 81 overall grade, because again, he is a guy who doesn't have too many flaws, and also just again, is a very solid prospect. Yeah, the potential isn't elite, but it is very, very good, and I would not be mad for anybody if you guys drafted him, because this guy, yeah, his tackling isn't great. He isn't the greatest off the ball, but again, when you watch him play, it's not an issue because of the fact, again, he's an elite zone corner, which again, I think could be very big for him going to it. I don't know, maybe the Jaguars, the Colts, you never know.
Hampton looking left, throwing left, and he's intercepted one more time. It's not number 27. It is number 27 again. Give him four.
Here she might choke.
This guy's a freaking dog, guys. There's no way around it. Quinyon Mitchell is a beast. Like, if I'm a corner, I'm just gonna, like, not, I mean, or my bad, a receiver, I'm just not gonna run my route against him, because this guy just, he's a baller. Like, there's no way around it. 6 foot, 200 flat, that's how I'll put it. But, yeah, this guy's an awesome, yeah, I get the fact that he wasn't playing against anyone who's really that great. I mean, Malachi Corley, no, I don't even think he played against him. Maybe he did. Whatever, though. Yeah, he never really had to face anyone crazily, but yeah, this guy's just a straight-up dog, guys. There's no way around it. Again, 41 total tackles and interception, 18 PDs in 2023. Again, diamond ball. Yeah, 42 tackles, yeah, you get the point. Yeah, this guy's just a beast. I mean, again, we'll get a little more in-depth with him on film, though. Again, you can't really miss him. I mean, if you do, well, you'll see him at some point. Like, at least twice a game, he makes a player, like, is that even possible? I mean, there's really, oh, goodness. There's really another way to put it. But, again, he did play it for Toledo all 4 years. Again, last year, again, at interception, he did four of these, four interceptions and two pick sixes, and, of course, in 2022 with Toledo. Last year, yeah, maybe wasn't the same guy, but he didn't even get targeted nearly at the same volume he did in 2022. I think he at most got 4 targets, and that was only in one game. So, again, most targets in a game would probably be like 4 somewhere around there, I think. That's what it's called graph there. But overall, again, he's just awesome. He does get targeted over the middle a little bit, though, which I think, again, could be a little bit of a big issue for him. Again, not going to be any really that great talented quarterbacks. He feasted on that. Again, had the highest PFF grade among any corner last year at 91.5. Again, pretty well deserved. Again, he only get, like, I think it was like 4 catches, something ridiculous like that. But either way, getting into his grades. Man coverage, he never really gave up much separation really at all, man. I'll give it an 89, though, because, again, he did get some plays over the middle where, again, yeah, he probably could have sticked in the receiver a little better, got beat a little bit, but, again, he has very good recovery speed, like, very, very good. Zone coverage, it's special. I'm sorry, guys. There's no way around it. Like, he's a menace. Like, he just makes so many plays. I'm like, how the hell did he get there? Like, pre-snap. Like, Jesus. He's like a weapon in zone coverage. It's like awesome to see. Like, there's no one who does that. In press coverage, you rarely see him in press because he's just not super physical off the line, to be honest. So that's why I have to give him a 72 there. Again, he's just kind of an average press corner. You're seeing a lot in zone, a lot in man too. Again, his coverage abilities are insane. He's not obviously as good as Sauce Gardner in man. Sauce Gardner was probably the best man corner I've actually ever seen. So, yeah. Not there, but in zone coverage, he's a special zone cover corner. Like, he's just him. Yeah, that just can't, there's no way around it. Standard, though, I don't know. I'll give him a, being honest, guys, I'll probably give him a 77. Again, I know you're saying, standard coverage, no, like, it's not the end of the world. Just, again, he's okay. Physicality, though, he's not super physical. That's actually something I think he definitely working going into the league. He will get knocked around if he does. Again, he is a dog, but he will get knocked around if he doesn't, again, amp that up a little bit. And never really had to go up against any of these brutal receivers. Off-snap explosiveness, very good, 84. Ball skills, he does drop a lot of interceptions, so that is something to keep in mind here. Again, it will be frustrating for whoever drafts him. He will, again, probably drop a pick 6 or 2 in the season, but his ball skills, again, are probably around average just because of that. But again, he does make some big interceptions, diving picks as well. Just not very consistent, again, when it comes to that coordination. Playmaking ability, yeah, that's going to come out to around a 90. He's an elite playmaker, guys. There's no way around it. Yeah, his ball skills aren't great, but again, when it comes to actually making plays, he does make them, again, a lot. Speed, it's not elite. It's just not. So I got to give it an 88. But he's got really good speed. He can burn those wheels for sure. He's not the fastest corner we're going to go through today. But he is very fast. I just don't think he has that extra gear that I think would be necessary for him to be that true boundary that could basically afford to give up, I don't know, 10 yards of separation and just like a Russell Wilson bomb and still get there in time to break up a pass. I don't think he has that speed. But he does have very, very good speed, can recover really well. Hip fluidity, smooth. 78, though, because I do think, again, he does get flipped around a little bit too much. He can't afford to give those up. Agility, especially against the run, you can fake about it a pretty decent bit. It does require him to dive sometimes when he tests to tackle. Again, not pretty poor technique in that way. But, again, his agility outside of that is very good. Play recognition, I mean, he knows what's going to happen, guys. Yeah, 100. It's a cheat code. Reading the quarterback, again, this is probably going to come around. I'm going to give it a 94 again. I don't know. I'll give it a 92. 89. His play recognition, again, there's no way, again, you can get around it. He's probably, every play, he knows what's going to happen. So, it's instinct. It's everything. Like, you can't ignore that. But I do think a quarterback like Patrick Mahomes or Josh Allen or Lamar, probably not Lamar Jackson, but you get the point there, could beat him into overrunning a play. So, I'm not going to say he reads the quarterback at an elite level, because, again, he's just basically read every single quarterback like a book in the MAC. But going to the NFL, I think that could be a little bit of an issue for him. But, again, he dominated quarterbacks in the MAC. There's no way around it. On film, he's just every play, he knows where the ball is going. So, I get that, but in the league, I think quarterbacks could manipulate him. So, that's why, I'll probably give him an 83 because of that. Concentration, he does concentrate pretty well. Again, not always the greatest, so I'll probably give it a 74. Again, does have lapses here and there. Again, especially, again, when it comes to catching those gift pick sixes. Quickness, very quick corner, 88. Length, it's kind of mediocre. Again, he does make a lot of diving picks, but again, he does get boxed out at times too. Tackling, it's pretty crap. I'm not going to lie, guys. It's bad. don't know, I'll give him like a 43. It's not good. He misses a lot of tackles. Truth. Discipline, though. 82. Even when he does get... Oh, shoot. Yeah, I like... Even when he does, again, he does completely get, okay, the very rare times he has gotten beat by the quarterback or the receiver on a route, he right back into the play because he, again, the discipline. He's like, oh, shoot, just a little bit back. Again, it's very subtle, what it's called when he commits. It's very subtle. Athleticism, 85. I think he's a really good athlete. I don't think he's an elite athlete, but he's very good. And the testing numbers tell you that all the time. His RS, I think it's like a 9-point something. It's really high, but I don't think he's that good. Again, on film, he doesn't play like an elite athlete, even though, of course, he's a very good one. Potential, Corey Ballantyne, again, ignore what he did with, like, the first 4 years of his career. 2023, he was really good for, like, a very valuable asset for the Packers. I really do think he has, maybe not the highest upside in this draft class, but I'm going to give him a 92. I think he has an elite potential going in the league, guys. Well, maybe not probably not. 88. I think he could be a little bit disappointing for whoever drafts him, but considering just how, like, unbelievable he was in college for Toledo, and just, again, how great he was on film, again, he's just really freaking good, guys. There's no way around it.
First and 10. Richardson taking a deep shot downfield. Oh!
Got the shooters in the corner like the pack in. She think cause she's at it, bitch, she a track, yeah.
And our next guy would be the Missouri Tiger. That is Ennis Rakestraw Jr., who is a physical bear. I guess you can honestly call him a tiger of a corner. This guy, he's not fun to run routes against. Simple as that. Again, matchup, a nightmare for some receivers. Not all, though. Again, he does have his limitations. But overall, Ennis Rakestraw Jr. is a very intriguing prospect. 35 tackles, 4 passes defended. Forced fumble, stuff like that. Yeah. Day 2 might be a little bit... I think it'll be a surefire day 2 pick. I think he could go in the back in the first round, to be honest. Oh, yeah. That's... We already talked about him. There we go. Yeah. 80.7 PFF grade. Again, that was the top 100 for corners. Again, baseline for him last year in terms of performance. There we go. All right, Ennis Rakestraw Jr. again played 4 years at Mizzou. He actually started, I think it was like 4 games in 2021. So that was, 2020 as a freshman. So that's pretty cool. Senior season, though, got 35 tackles, 1.5 tackles for loss, 4 pass defending, 4 fumble as the number one corner for the Tigers. Either way, though, again, looking at him, we can do his comparison. We'll get to that later. But Ennis Rakestraw Jr., again, here are his grades. Either way, man coverage, I think he's actually a really good man player. Dependable, for sure, 85. Again, I really like what I saw from him last year, especially in man. Again, just doesn't, like, literally sticks to a guy like glue. Yes, we'll get into a couple other things later that do have issues with that. But again, on those deep balls, you never really see him, like, at back end at all. Even then, he does recover pretty well. Zone coverage, he's kind of a brick in zone overall, kind of just against a guy like sitting there in empty space, but he does stick to his area very, very well, and also can, again, get on the ball at a very high speed as well. Press coverage, it's sloppy, but I like the potential, so I'll give it a 76. Standard coverage, again, just sitting there. Again, he does get a little uncomfortable. Again, he likes off a lot, which, again, I think is going to be a little bit of an issue in the league, again, in terms of his tackling not being up to par right now. But I'll give it a 74. Again, it just does no limitations. Just, I don't think he's really sat into a good coverage. Again, his leverage ability is not great. Physicality, he's very physical. Not always, he's aggressively physical at times. I'll give it an 88, though, because, again, he can light guys up. Snap explosiveness, actually really solid. I like his burst a lot. I'm not going to say it's really good because, again, he does get burned sometimes, but I do like what I see there. Ball skills, he does have, again, he's kind of a brick in zone, so, again, he's not always going to get those opportunities too well. All right, but on jump balls, he is very dependable to, again, be the one who knocks the pass away. Playmaking ability, he does have some issues here for sure. Again, I think sometimes he just, doesn't read the play very well. And again, on a play where he did have an opportunity to get a pick six, it's more like an incompletion. Again, doesn't have the highest ceiling on those things. Speed, it's decent, nothing special. I'll probably give it a 77, but again, the way he does play, it's not really too much of an issue. Hip fluidity, very good, 88, not 88, I'll give it an 86. Very, very good hip fluidity. Again, hips flip very fluidly, and it's just like every single play, like, he's there as expected. Very good at timing those plays up. Agility, I don't know, 77. Again, his balance when he runs into guys is a little bit of a problem, but again, he is able to stand him up somewhat well, which is why I'll give him above average there. Play recognition, kind of trash, not gonna lie. I mean, I said it like that too. I just don't want to, like, be mean. I kind of mean, but yeah. You think that he'd be better here, but he's just not. reading the quarterback again, the eyes wise, again, you look at what is called the top taper of the helmet. He is looking in the backfield a little bit too much sometimes, though. And again, I think, again, if he was a little quicker in processing the quarterback there, I think he could be a lot better. And it has, again, this is a lot of room to improve there. Concentration, I think this is just something he'll never be the best in. He's, again, just kind of, like, awkward, especially in those high, what is called air yard passes. He just doesn't have the concentration to always, again, be the most, what is called, effective with his techniques. Quickness, I don't know, 72. He's not the quickest guy in the world. Never really had to be either. You're not going to see him cover too many slots, guys. Length, his length is actually really good, in my opinion. Again, you see a lot on film for sure. Again, if he just can become a little more refined and, again, doesn't panic as much, it'd be a lot better. Tackling, again, he doesn't always tackle with the best technique, but overall, again, he does bring the guy down, which, again, is the goal of, again, a legal tackle. Illegal, not illegal. Discipline, it's an issue. I gotta give this probably a 30, guys. He makes, again, when the ball is in the air and he doesn't know where it is, he panics. It happens, like, a lot. So, if he can get better there and he doesn't flip out too much, I think NS Racer Jr. could be a lot better. But, yeah, that discipline needs a lot of work for sure. He gets flagged a lot. Athleticism, though. He's actually a very good athlete, 86. I think this could actually really stick within the league. And he doesn't look like it is, but, again, he has a lot of potential there. Which means, again, Marco Wilson, who's comparison, again, I don't really see NS Racer as a number one corner in the league. You just can't depend on him with all those penalties to really be, again, that true number one. But as a number two on the outside boundary, you can keep him there 5 years. Again, yeah, there'll be penalties, there'll be issues, but you can overall rely on him to, again, cover that side of the field very well in man. But again, I think it's a big part of the team. Again, Marco Wilson had to do that in 2022. Again, without Byron Murphy last year, he did struggle as a number one. But going to the Patriots this year, again, I think, what is it called? Gerard Mayo. We'll put him in a really good spot. So, again, if he can land somewhere, again, he doesn't have to be that number one corner. The Packers, he could be very good for them. Again, replace a guy like Eric Stokes. This is not his actual grade, but again, his discipline is a big issue right now.
Pass protection by that O-liner, critical.
Cook, time, fires, Burton, can't hold it.
Up at the station, and the model's still the same. Fire like I want to.
I mean, hey, Cardinals, you guys want to build a cornerback room? I mean, looking at your guys' room right now, yeah, this is not good. Garrett Williams, Sean Murphy Bunny, I mean, he's decent, but you get the point there. They could use two corners, guys. So that was a bad voice crack. But the point still remains, guys. Kamari Lassiter, yes, of course, the man out of Georgia, another Georgia Bulldog. You might think, yeah, he'll go to the Eagles at whatever. What is it, 22? No, higher than that, like 20, no, higher than that. I don't know. What is it, 26? Something like that. Yeah, he's just going to go there like, well, we get it. But more importantly, guys, that's kind of like a lazy take. Just simple truth about that. But Kamari Lassiter, again, the reason I, again, brought up the Cardinals is because his comparison, which I really like a lot, is Byron Murphy Jr. Because he is a very disciplined corner. Again, that's why at Georgia, Kirby Smart just said, go out there and play their number one guy every single week. And he delivered. Yes, he's not the most, like, overwhelming corner. He's not going to get, he's going to be a little boring. It's truth about it. But the way he plays is a way to be a sustainable number one corner in the league. Simple as that. He's not one of the best guys, that's for sure, but he's got a lot of good stuff I like, and he's a little light, not the tallest, but whatever. Yeah, 37 tackles, 8 PDs. Again, he looks really good, impressive. Smothering receivers, providing separation. Yeah, he doesn't get much separation. Again, that's what number one corners do, obviously. Kamari Lassiter, 37 tackles, 3 and a half tackles for loss, half a sack, 8 passes defended. Yeah, you get the point there. He only had one interception in his career. That will be, I think, something that, again, he'll work on going into the league for sure. But again, he did have 85.4 PFF grade, which was 35th among all cornerbacks in college football last year. Again, Byron Murphy Jr. is a comparison. That will be his potential. But either way, man coverage. He's a good man corner. Again, nothing crazy. I'll give him an 83, though. But the lack of separation he gives up, I think, is a big part of his game. Zone coverage, not as good, but it's still good enough, I guess. I mean, never gonna wow, never gonna take a big interception, never gonna be like, holy crap, he like had no chance there as a receiver. But again, he's decent enough. Maybe doesn't have those true natural instincts, but they're good. Press coverage, 84. He is a pretty good press corner. Nothing like elite, but he is a really, honestly, probably really good, to be honest, guys. Because he's consistent. Like, it's hard. Again, he really does jam receivers really low. Gets into their grill. Like, it's kind of hard to get open against him like that. But I don't think, like, he and uses it to a clip where you're like, oh, God. Yeah, you know what's coming every play. But he's still good. He doesn't, like, he can't rely on it, but it is good. Standard sets. Again, pretty comfortable in him. I'll give him a 78. Physicality and physical corner for sure. He does harass receivers really well. Off-snap explosiveness, not good. Probably like a 66, but again, when he doesn't have to worry about it, it's pretty good. Ball skills, again, it's really kind of about focus, so I'll give it an 81. I actually don't think his ball skills are that bad at all. Playmaking ability. Yeah, that's definitely lacking. 57. He's not gonna make too many huge plays. Speed. It's good. I think, yeah, 81. It's really good, but it's getting right on that line. It's above average, but it's not like, it's like, I don't know. I gotta put it here, guys. Hip fluidity. Being honest, guys, it's nothing special. Probably give it honestly a dead average there. Agility. It's a little better, but nothing getting crazy. He does have good balance. Play recognition. 84. He knows usually what's gonna happen. Ability to read the quarterback. I don't know about this one, guys, because I rarely see him make a play. I'm like, he was gonna get beat if he didn't know what was going on. So it's just like it's not, again, he doesn't really have I've never really seen him try to do this too much. Concentration. He's a little erratic, but I think it's, a controlled erratic, so I'll give it an 85, because, again, that's really hard to do. That body control is not easy to contain, Ennis Rickshaw Jr. saw. Quickness, he's a quick corner for sure. I'll probably give this an 84. It's really good. Length, 62. This is what he lacks. Again, that's what Byron Murphy Jr. lacks. That's why he gives up high ratings. What it's called in the stats. He gives a lot of underneath stuff, high completion percentage. That's what it's called. I think Kamari Lassiter will struggle with, if he does struggle with something, in his rookie year. Tackling, it's solid. I'll give it a 78. He wraps up pretty well. Again, sound technique for sure. Again, he can get ran over a little bit sometimes, but I don't think, again, the biggest deal with him. Discipline, again, very calm, disciplined corner. Calm, cool, collected. Big there. Athleticism, it's okay. I'm not, going crazy over it. Potential, 80. I think he will be a number one corner in the league. Will he be a great one? No. Do I think he could be above average? Yeah. Might actually be an average number one corner, which, again, is not easy to find. That's a hard guy to find. That's 32. That's not even 32 guys in the league, guys. Simple truth about it. It's rare to find what is called an instance where 32 corners in the league are true number ones, but I think he could be that. So, again, doesn't have crazy potential. I think he does have a low ceiling, but that ceiling is, again, helped up by a low floor, which, again, is going to be a starting caliber corner, which, again, Byron Murphy Jr. is a very controlled player, obviously. Again, a member of the Minnesota Vikings. Now, he got a second contract, guys. That tells you what type of guy he is. Again, different than Marco Wilson, but, again, I do think Byron Murphy Jr. and Kamari Lassiter fit like a glove as a comparison. Very good one there. But that's what we got there again. On film, very, very good. Get the point there. All right, 73.7. Pretty fair for him.
Third down and long. Thompson to throw. Now flushed. And thrown away. Intercepted. Nate Wiggins. And he will score.
These hoes hungry. They gon' fuck for a name. I put her on the game. She get fucked for a chain. Got your girl in it.
Alright, guys, we are now on Nate Wiggins, the last corner before we go into our overall rankings. After he, of course, he was the Clemson Tiger last year, and obviously the year before that, and blah, 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 blah. You get the point, though. Was the fast guy outside, of course, the record-breaking Xavier Worthy in the NFL Draft Combine. Of course, ran a 4.28. He's 173.61. If you don't remember back to that Combine recap, I did talk a lot about Nate Wiggins. Of course, he did get that injury. He will be ready for what it's called. Rookie minicamp, but you get the point there. Again, he will probably be drafted in the first round. There's, no way around it there. I mean, maybe he doesn't. Team's going to screw him. They could do that, but I think that would be a pretty moronic decision, in my opinion. Either way, though, Nate Wiggins is a beast, guys. Yeah, that's what I really think about him, but, yeah, again, he does have some issues against the run. I really don't care about that, because you'll see why in a second, but, yeah, as a senior, I guess, kind of last year, I guess you call him that, 29 total tackles, of course, two interceptions, one was 2-4 pick 6, I think that was against FAU, 6 passes defended, 2 forced fumbles, 1 sack and 1 tackle for loss. This guy is a playmaking machine in that sense. He does flash screen. Obviously, he had that play against Nick Hampton. I don't know if it was Nick Hampton. It was the running back for UNC, and he had the interception that game as well against Drake May. He showed out in that one, obviously. Prevented a touchdown as well in that breakaway run. He just completely came out of nowhere. 82.5, PF grade, though, 55th ranked corner last year by them. But Nate Wiggins, again, Cordell Flott, that's just, the worst comparison I've ever seen. Yeah, I get the fact, again, weak run offenders, they're fast. Yeah, that's similar about him, but that's really as far as it goes. Because Cordell Flott was trash coming out of college in terms of his, overall technique and coverage. Nate Wiggins is much better than that. Either way, though, in man, 86, he does tend to give up separation at a little bit. But the problem with, what it's called, when you're going against a guy like him, you could beat him over the top and still, be well out of reach to actually make a play in the football. Because he will get there in time no matter what. Zone coverage, not that great, to be honest. He's a little lazy, to be honest. But, it's still really good because of the fact that, again, he does the speed and the discipline, actually, in my opinion, to actually be good here. Press coverage, you don't see too much of this because, again, he just really doesn't jam receivers too well. I'll give him a 74 there. Standard coverage, again, super comfortable here. He's super confident. It's 90. He's an elite set on what is called front set corner. Physicality, not really physical too much, to be honest, guys. I think, again, bigger receivers will dominate him in that facet. Not as much as I think, again, you'll see, though, at times. Off-snap explosiveness, he fires like a rocket. Like, you talk about Aquinion Mitchell, Toledo Rocket, he's Toledo Rocket. It's borderline on some special off the snap, because, again, faster, honestly, you could probably cover Tyreek Hill right now. Ball skills, they're good, not elite, but they are really good. I'll give him an 84. Playmaking ability, 96. No, it's not as good as Quinion Mitchell. I don't know. Probably an 87. Speed, 95. This guy's fast as frick. I mean, yeah. That's just the way around it. I mean, he's not, like, again, the fastest I've ever seen, but he does have special speed. Like, that's what flashes on you guys. Yeah, simple as that. He's basically a sprinter. Hip fluidity, it's actually really, really smooth. A little awkward, but it is really good. Agility, he does have elite agility. I'll give this a 91. Yeah. Play recognition, he kind of is more reactive for sure. His instincts definitely rely on helping him out there. A read of the quarterback, again, he's kind of lazy. He just kind of does that. That's really all he does, and he's still not that great at it, so I'll give it a 77. Concentration, again, he just gets lazy. Lack of focus, I think, will undo him at times. 53. Quickness, he's quick. Not too quick, though. I think, again, he could get really, really growing this way, but yeah, I'll give him an 84. Length, he actually is really long, a lot more than people would think he would be. 88. Tackling, kind of trash, 51. It's not as bad as Quinion Mitchell, though. That's all I'll put it there. Discipline, in coverage, he's actually really disciplined. Again, he might be a little ignorant at times, but he really never gets out of what is called his lane, I guess, as you could say. Athleticism, 94. He is a special athlete, guys. I really do think so. Yeah, he might not have the unicorn-ness that, again, in terms of size, but, guys, he's just a freaking athlete. It's almost that. Again, you can put him in a lot of different spots, and he'll still thrive there, guys. Potential. I really do think this guy could be a first-team All-Pro corner. Like, I'll be honest. I'm not going to say a special talent because he's not an elite prospect, but I'm going to give him a 91, guys. Again, there's no way you could tell me that there's a better, like, again, cover corner in this draft class. There just isn't. So I'll give him a 91 for his potential. I think he has the best potential in this whole entire draft. And, again, Cordero Flash is just a freaking lazy comparison. Let's get to our overall rankings now. Alright, guys, of course, we are now in our rankings going through these 8 guys. I gave Cooley McKinstry a 77.9, right on the fringe of the 78, but I don't think at this point he is in a really good prospect. He's a good prospect, but again, just the fact that, again, I think there are some limitations with him, obviously, as a zone player, and again, as a playmaker, that could hinder his ability to truly, again, be that really effective, down-to-down, like, dominant corner. Cooper DeJean, 76.5. Obviously, he is the most versatile player in this entire draft. It's, like, not even close to argument there. But, obviously, there are issues, obviously, with his hip fluidity. Again, it's bad. There's no way around that, guys. But, on film, again, I think he could be a very successful player in the NFL. It's just finding him that right rhythm, of course, playing outside in the slot and, obviously, as a safety as well. So, we'll see if they can get that right. But, obviously, as a cornerback, 76.5 overall grade for him. I think he's a good player. TJ Ciampa, again, doesn't impress me too much. He has just, again, a couple more weaknesses than all these other guys. And the fact that, again, he doesn't have that downfield speed, I think that could hurt him at times in the league. But as a starting corner, definitely could see that someday. Again, nothing can be anything crazy. He has a lower ceiling, but, again, a good prospect for sure. Terran Arnold, 81.9. Again, he has a lot of good things going his way right now. Again, I like him a lot. Again, zone corner, very, very good. Not the best, but he's very, very good. And, again, should be a good true number one in the league. Quinion Mitchell, again, this guy's a freaking dog. There are questions about his physicality, again, his ability to play against really good players. But even come down to it, guys, he's the best zone corner I've come across, really, I think, in, like, at least 3 years. So the fact that he's, again, coming out like that, he should be very happy about. Ennis Rickshaw Jr., 74.1, again, the discipline's a big issue, but as an actual player, he is a dog, and I really think, again, he could be successful if he doesn't panic on those deep balls. Kamara Lassiter, again, lower ceiling, but he has a lot of good things, again, going for him as well, and, again, should be able to become a number one corner in the league, and also be super reliable. And obviously, yeah, I left the best for last, guys. Nate Wiggins, 85.2 overall grade for him. Again, of course, we've gone the overall rankings in a second, but I love Nate Wiggins, guys. He's just, I don't know, after I saw it, that first, what it's called, on film, and then watched that play he made against, what it's called, UNC, I'm like, yeah, this is the guy's the best corner. Yeah, probably the best DB in this draft class. Yes, he's not great against everyone. I really don't care because of how talented he is, what it's called, as a cover corner. Again, overall 85.2, that's around like a Pro Bowl caliber prospect, which I really do think he is. Quinion Mitchell and Terry Arnold, both very, very good prospects as well. Cole McKinstry, not in that tier, but he's right below them. Cooper DeJean, just again, the value he provides, he's probably around Cole McKinstry's range. Kamari Lassiter and Rick Starr are also pretty good. Again, TJ Temple, yeah, again, he's an average prospect. That's why he's on this eighth spot. But again, I still think he's a pretty good player as well. Again, all these guys should, I mean, maybe TJ Temple doesn't go in the first round, but again, with all the depth in this draft class, in need for corner, I think this is actually a very solid draft class. We're getting a reinvigorated group of corners going to the NFL. I think is a big deal. This is my favorite part of the I'm going to call it NFL draft with this position group, at least in 2024. Those are my what is called rankings 1-8, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed, and you can screenshot this, do whatever you need to do. You can go in what is called draft season. Again, the draft is now 3 weeks away, but until then, hope you guys enjoy, and yeah, see you for our next prospect videos, which will, of course, will be on Saturday.
Canvas on the ice. No undercard tonight. Rempe and McDermott, the main event to open the hockey game.
Both sides. Lazar went the other side as well.
Jimmy Vesey and Lazar. Gaudreau has dropped them with Kevin Ball as well.